So yeah, this was really stupid, because I started thinking about it and I was making it UBAC constrained. See, my one shot is UBAC constrained, but UBAC, this isn't UBAC, this is MCS. So I just made a bug in the policy, I think. So that's really stupid. So it's not a UBAC constraint type, it's MCS constraint. Damn. So hopefully that'll solve it now. Because I was basically just losing my mind there. So try that again. System control start my one shot system, and it failed. Yeah, the status doesn't show much because it's full of crap. But anyways, let's have a look at the out search MAVC TS 1333, and here it's actually, this is actually what's going on here. So now it wants to search that one shot data there, but the data there is actually with category 2 while the process is with category 1. So that now it actually works. So now if I make the process unit file here, if I make that with C2, then it's going to work. Still not working. Oh, I need the system control daemon reload probably, and now it works. And if now do guts, then this is 1336, this is it. So that now it works. So that's basically how the MCS stuff works. Okay, now let's just use type enforcement instead, which is a little bit more complicated. So let's just open that my one shot policy, my one shot TE, and I'll just basically try this, but this is not going to work. I'm going to try it anyways. So basically I'm going to say my other one shot and then remove this, and then my other one shot, and then this is the same, or actually no, that's not the same, my other one shot, my other one shot, and this is the same. Actually not the same, my change that. But now we're going to get into probably a conflict. I'll remove this one here. This is now nothing serious. So so the same file. It's pretty confusing stuff, this. But now it's probably not going to build because you have a conflict here. Yeah, hello, where are you? Well, it builds, but it probably won't install. There should be some duplicate in there, a duplicate type domain transition. But it actually installs. Let's have a look at the file again, because it's kind of in the daemon domain, my one shot. Yeah, see, it, that's because I didn't do that right. Because if I do this right, the way it should be, then it won't work. Yeah, where are you? Now it won't install if all is well, if it makes sense. Supposedly a duplicate type transition. Yeah, see? That's what it says. It's a conflicting type enforcement rule. This is weird, but this is not related. It just gives you this stupid, obscure message which has nothing to do. Well, it has a little bit to do with it, but so what we're going to do is we're going to have a look at the init daemon domain in Fedora modules system and the init daemon domain. Init daemon domain, where are you? Here's the init daemon domain. And oh, that's messed up. That's really messed up here. What does it say? This is messed up. So init rc domain, it has probably has to do with that. But that's basically all it is, and domain. actually we have three attributes here. Direct init entry. Okay, let's just do it the other way. Actually, so instead of doing it this way, let's just make it a little bit different. So let's just paste this in here. So we want to, because if we do this here, it just doesn't work. Let's just try this instead. Let's just first my one shot T daemon. We need to require those. My one shot T exactly. Require those gen require then attribute domain and direct init entry. That takes care of this. Now this we need domain type. Is this going to make it that more complicated? My one shot T, my one shot T, my one shot exec T, my one shot exec T, and then type transition init T init. And this actually this might actually be enough. I'm not sure. Let's just try this out, and then if it doesn't work, then we'll fix it. Then obviously keep that in. string at line 6. Oh yeah. Attribute daemon is not declared. Right. Unknown type, my udder. The typos, yeah, that's because I'm kind of panicking. Which I shouldn't do. But I'm also racing against the clock, of course, so that's also a reason why I'm trying to do this as fast as possible. Do I have any? I don't have anything. Okay, then let's get let's file. It's been a while since I last getted it. And now it runs an init.rc. Right. Right. That's because I need to update the etc systemd system and then my one shot, and that's not it. This is it. So now I need to basically add a type. Type my one shot T. Okay, so now. Oh yeah, and that what's happening here? Grant. Oh, there's a grant. These are grants. I should remove those from my policy. So now I have the policy for my one shot. My one shot TE. And I have here an audit allow, which I can remove, so I don't want to see that. So now basically I have the two domains. So let's just make their serve instance 2, and then restore conv instance 2, serve instance 2. And let's reset my other one shot. Now let's just cd, or actually cp etc system, and then my one shot service to etc system, my other one shot service. Then restore con .v. And that's set, and then edit that file. Actually, yeah, and I edit that to my other. I'll make it to the file also, and then instance 2, and then yeah, label that file that dir s0 tcon t l sorry s0 c2. And now system control start my other instance. My other. What is it? One shot. Failed. Less for log audit log. Oh yeah, we're right. Huh? Let's have a look at the policy again. Oh yeah, there's a bug here. My other. Now and then basically, hello, where are you? Basically at some point you can create some template so that you don't have to basically write this stuff all over again if you want to create new. So you can basically create a template that automatically creates a new unit file and a new policy in a reasonable simple way using a policy template, where you can basically, where it just expects a single parameter like prefix, like for example my other one shot, and then it creates all these rules automatically, and it creates a unit file automatically, and then basically you're done. So now system start my other instance, system start my instance or my one shot, and then basically get them both, get serve my other one shot. Oh my damn, that's so inconsistent. Instance 2, is it? Well, I'll be damned. So here's that for 2, and here's the one for 1, and it's basically both at 35.6. The latest. So now you basically have MCS and type enforcement, and then you can basically, if you want to basically, I can also show you that. So nano user has been and then my one shot. So now basically I can give if S2 equals and then do something that you shouldn't be able to do. Actually, So basically what we're going to do is that if S2 equals extra, then they'll do something that the other one isn't allowed to do. So then ping C1 www google.com and right, so something like that. Not sure if this is going to work. And then I'll make two with the extra. Where are you? And then I'll set instance two extra. Enough to do. So now, but if the thing isn't buggy, oh yeah, set a force 0, and then out search m avgts 1404 01. We clean. Yeah, we clean. System control start my other one shot, and then it doesn't work. That doesn't work. Why doesn't that work? This is so annoying. Oh yeah, equals. Yeah, it's not equals, it's is. Now it works. I'll search MAVCTS 4001 audit to allow less. That's not less, probably not that much. Now anyways, so we can basically just add this here, and I'll just do a audit to allow R, and then just my one shot D, and then that just basically adds the rules nano. See, so basically adds the rules there. So now set and force, actually make that as a module that and then set and force, and then try that again and see if it works. Still works. Because some stuff is actually denied if you test it in enforcer mode. See? I'll search ABCTS. Always try it in enforcing as well, obviously. It's silently denied. Something is silently denied, probably, likely. It's messy. That's a Fedora issue. See what's happening here, yeah. See, that's that read write. Because Fedora thinks that's a leak file descriptor, but it isn't. Now, security, I don't need to read that, but this one. And actually, let's just try that in a permissive mode again, set of force. Maybe that shows a little bit more, because that's more where that came from. You see? So let's just add that as well. Make that. Not going to figure out what it all means. I'm just going to try and make it work. And then it's up to you to make sense out of it. But there's some, yeah, it's not actually a leak. It's probably. Because if it was, then it wouldn't have worked, or maybe it fails on that it can't read security. That's probably it, or not sure actually. Set enforce one and see if it now works. Now it works. So as a module B to get rid of the don't audits. So one of these rules that we added was responsible for it failing. Which one of it? Which one is it? I don't know. So you can figure that out by just basically adding a single rule at a time and see which one of it makes it works. Work. Maybe only one. Maybe you need only one of these three, or maybe you need them all. I don't know. So now basically you have the policy. So now, for example, if I go to the one and try to do this, try to run one with extra. So where is it? God damn it. So my one shot, and I try that, run that with extra, then it will fail because this one isn't allowed to do that. And of course I probably need to update, yeah, that is, oh actually, see, but it fails. So yeah, that's expected, because it's doing something that it isn't supposed to do. So that's basically the whole story. So you have now both, see, it's trying to get attribute of ping, but it isn't allowed, but our other one shot, my other one shot is allowed to do that. So that works fine. So that's the type enforcement part of it, where one, where basically one domain has permissions that the other one doesn't have, and then we have also MCS for isolation. So I can also, if I change, for example, let's just change this back without the extra, but let's just. give it another category, category one, then you'll have another AVC denial, another of another nature. Now let's try that again with 1409. Because now it can't actually, it didn't update. It didn't update. I need to daemon reload. Still, it still has that old one in its mind. Something you have to get used to. Weird. It works, so not, that's not right. So it actually did work, but it didn't actually where's that instance one? God damn it. Yeah, instance one. Something around at about 1410. But it wasn't there. Because this actually was the process running with C1. So, and it was happening at 1410. And so, that's not it. So let's try that again. So although it seems to work, it hasn't added any entry, so it didn't work. And if you look at our search at 4011, I guess, then you'll see the denial, and that's MCS for you. So yeah, that's basically the whole kit and caboodle. Now you can basically optimize that by using templates. So you basically create a template to create new domains so that you can easily have a base domain and then extend that easily. And you can also create a script to create a new a unit files quickly. But if you do it like this, then yeah, then you can achieve that easily. So you have a single executable file that basically allows various options, and these options basically need permissions, and so you use type enforcement to basically limit the permissions that a domain has. And so some options might work with this domain, some options might work with the other domain, and you have the overall isolation where one process of the same command can't access the other data of the other process of the same command. Actually, that's basically what it is. So yeah, that's it, that's it all.